That's running really nicely.
It looks really much smoother than before. It starts to fix with the tank.
Yeah.
Where the tension is in that. So you understand a lot to see that, I reckon. Because that's the one where there's quite a stiff diameter high. I'll stress it out a bit more. And I've got on a very low gear, but this is just our first test of that ring system, and that's looking so much easier to handle. It was easy to put up and set the tension in it. On the main line, all I did was tie off on the middle of the crank. So here we are from the side, yeah, right enough. That top ring there. That gradation from the small medium needs to be a bigger one there as we step up. Just like before, we said that the rings run off a better, bigger one in front. Center line is blown and it seems to have gone down the bottom here. It's where, you know, it's rubbing on the end piece there. Seems to have been the problem. It snapped on something rough there. You can see that used to be connected down to the center of the crank. It's still running all right. You see the tension seems pretty good in those lower tethers. Everything's still working as it diverts through the outer. Let's have a look at the top. So everything's running. I know, it's still tense to the, it's still tense to there, you see that? So it's still got the same tension as it had there before. There'll be slightly more on these lines. And they're looking quite set, so that has flattened that a bit, I think. Yeah, you see how... you see the loose line in the middle there. Interesting, but it's all the tension. Yeah, it is too, isn't it? That's the first collapse we've had today. All the tension is on the outside now, so that will want to be inner, as that's focusing toward the disc below because that's smaller. It might well be that the center line has hooked onto that. So we'll look. It's good to see how it does break though. That's